The minimal design of Samsung's TV remote is surely appreciated by many, myself included, most of the time. But if you're not careful, it can be easily misplaced. So today we're going to go over how to operate your Samsung TV without the remote, and this includes turning it on and off, which, as simple as it is also very helpful. The first thing you'll want to do is download the SmartThings app to your mobile device. And as you'll see in a second, this app can control a lot more than just the TV. So keep that in mind if you have other Samsung or compatible products. Also, if you haven't created a Samsung account yet, you may be prompted to do so before you get to the app's real functionality. But once that's done, setup is super simple, provided your TV and phone are connected to the same Wi-Fi network. On the device's screen, you'll see the plus sign in the top right corner, which is used to add devices. From there, you have the option of Samsung or partner devices, and we'll choose Samsung since this is a Samsung product. And yeah, there are a lot of potential devices to add, from air conditioners to microwaves to washers and dryers. When we scroll down to TV, the app begins searching for devices, and I quickly see my Samsung QN90C listed. Once the device is chosen, to verify, you're given a PIN code on the TV screen to enter on the phone. Once everything is connected, your device is registered to your account and you're good to go. This is where you can also make changes within the app to the device location and device name. But now to the good stuff, controlling your TV from your phone. On the Devices tab, I'll press the icon for the TV that was just connected, and immediately a virtual remote pops up with the same layout as my normal TV remote, including the power button, directional pad, home button, and more. So, no brainer here, if I want to turn the TV off with the phone, I just press the power button. I can do the same to turn it back on. And it actually functions pretty quickly without much more delay than you'd get from the physical remote. Also worth noting, this remote that's just taking up half of the phone screen can be expanded. Swipe up on the two dashes in the middle and now you have access to the channel and volume controls as well. And one more thing you can do from the app if you really want to make it your go-to remote, at the top in the sources and apps section, you can go directly to those with one press instead of navigating to it with your remote. That's it for this one, guys. I hope this is something that can help you with your everyday Samsung TV viewing. Don't forget, if you've got specific or more complex questions about some of these home theater topics, you can send questions to youasked@digitaltrends.com for Caleb Dennison to answer within that series.